All right, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Nate. I'll be your guest commentator for the evening. I'm watching this fight with Mason Teeters and Romero.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is scheduled for 3 4-minute rounds for the DC Amateur Flyweight Championship. It is brought to you by Downing and Erbaum Law Offices. We fight to win. Introducing first the challenger, fighting out of the G&G Smoke Shop blue corner. He's a freestyle fighter, standing 5'4", weighed in at 129.2 pounds, holding an amateur record, 6 wins, 2 defeats. Training out of Legacy MMA and fighting out of Omaha, Nebraska, Mason Teeters. His opponent across the DC cage, fighting out of the Nebraska Lottery red corner. He's a wrestler, standing 5'3", weighed in 127 pounds. Holding an amateur MMA record, 4 wins, 1 defeat. Training at the Next Edge Academy in Finance, Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Ladies and gentlemen, your defending, reigning DC Amateur Flyweight Champion, Robel Tesfaldi. Your referee is Pat McConaughey.
Keeping the legs split and now attacking the back of the thighs.
Last back in there, can you?
Just take good. Switching from belly down to.
Circle, circle, grind. Nice. Yeah.
Test, test, test. All right, there we go.
Pull that out quick.
Oh, Robiel getting some good strikes off. He might. Teeter's selling out on this leg lock. Ooh, that was a.
Watch that knee. Hips out wide, hips out wide.
Test, test. All right. Now I'm back.
Am I back?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay.
Sorry about the technical difficulties right now.
A lot of good ground and pound out of Robiel. I think Teeters needs to be careful selling on some of those leg locks. It's going to cost him.
Oh, yeah. Right now, you know, the pace is kind of slowing down. The champion right now, he's, you know, he's initiating his dominance. He's moving around. He's trying to put his combinations together. I like it so far, you know. His speed, his quickness. So right now, you know what? Oh, nice straight right.
Nice.
Nice comeback with the takedown, Robel. Now he's in side guard. Well, side mount, sorry. Side control.
Oh, we all have those moments.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, one thing I've noticed about Robiel, definitely a very talented wrestler. Good ground and pound, good game. Overall, just very talented, very good. If he'd have won an RFA fight, he probably would be pro right now. That kind of mixed things up.
Yeah. He's, you know, he, like I said, he came out, you know, he's shown, he's moving his footwork, his speed. He's coming out there, and he's showing the reason why he's a champion. You know, it's just overall right now, we have to see how the, you know, how the rest of the remainder rounds go. And I'm looking forward to see it. Cassius got the Childish Gambino locks going on.
Oh, Cass, we love you, buddy.
Oh, yeah, I love you, buddy. I just had to do that. We'll talk about it later. But I wonder how this second round is going to go. But both guys are pushing the pace, you know. You know, they're being hesitant to a certain extent, but at the same time, you know, they're going for it. They're not like holding back. You know, most people just literally just hold back and be afraid to do what they're trained to do. All right. Robel right now in the orthodox stance. Teeters in southpaw right now.
Thought at weigh-ins last night, Teeters looked really depleted. I think he had to come back and cut. He was overweight. Just looked like it took a toll. I think this might be his first fight at 125.
At 125.
If anything, it's his second. I'm pretty sure it's his first. Took on former bantamweight champion Mecca Fikindu.
Oh, yeah. Mecca, shouts out to you, Mecca. Congratulations on your pro debut win the other night in AFC. Good job, buddy.
And then, yeah, Legacy Martial Arts, more of a strikers. A few talented wrestlers out there. I like how Teeter's switching stances, you know.
Oh, yeah, man.
Keep things mixed up.
And see, and that's the thing about wrestlers, because I myself is a wrestler, you know. We come out there, we come to dominate, and we come to push for it. We take control. Oh, nice. Nice little flurry there.
Nice catch, nice. Robiel.
Teeter's coming, Robiel, with that straight right. That's the second time. Second time he caught him with that straight right.
Pressure. He's going to ask Gage.
But, yeah, you know, wrestlers, we, you know, we adapt. You know, we try to adapt to everything, environment, doesn't matter what it is, we try to adapt. And, you know, some wrestlers have success, some of them don't. Oh, he tried to, Robel tried to go in for a takedown, then and was swinging. Kind of left his chin kind of high. Well, a person like that, you know, speed, you know, it sometimes beats everything, you know, but at the same time, whoop. Nice takedown. But yeah, like I was saying, you know, speed, ladies and gentlemen, it, some people have it, some people don't. It's just a matter of how you use it, you know, and how you put it all together. Right now, Robel is, you know, he's moving consistently. He's not just sitting in one area. Like right now, transitioning from full guard to half guard. You know, both guys trying to gain dominant position right now. It's a battle. Right now, Robel got the full amount. We got less than 15 seconds in the second round in this championship bout. Nice elbow. Great round, both guys. Great round. So far, ladies and gentlemen, right now.
Now to the third and final round for the Flyweight Championship. Once again, this fight is brought to you by Dowding and Erbom Law Offices. We fight to win. Thank you very much to Dowding and Erbom Law Offices for your continued support, Dynasty Combat Sports.
All right, I'm back. Like right now, ladies and gentlemen, we're in our third and final round of this championship flyweight bout. And again, if you have just now tuning in, my name is Nate Smith. I'm MCL's flyweight champion. And right now, from depending on whoever wins, here's the fight news, ladies and gentlemen. Whoever wins this bout, I'm going to end up going in here, getting a stare off. I'm going to end up fighting for that belt. I want to add an extra belt to my repertoire, you know? And right now, both of these guys are warriors. They're coming out to fight. They're not holding anything back. One wants to win it, take the belt home with them, and become the new champion. The other one that remained the champion. And right now, we at that knit and grit. Who wants it more? Who wants to take that belt home? Right now, this round, we're going to find out. Nice right hand by Robel. Jesus is actually utilizing that jab. He's being aware for the takedowns. Nice takedown off the cage from Robel. Tears is kind of playing the butterfly guard inside and out. Right now in the half guard position. That corner is something no one should be in. You know, it's a dangerous position. Once you're in there, you can get stuck there and you won't be able to move. You know, that cage, that gate that's right there, there's no roll around. You can try to circle around, put your feet on it, hands, whatever, try to move yourself in a better position. But right now, you know, it's not going to happen. Robel right now has a very dominant position over Teeters, and we're going to see how this plays out right now. Getting to the full amount. He's in unleashing some ground and pound. He's giving up his back. Robel has his back. Let's see what's happening next. We have a minute and 30 seconds in the third round. It's plenty of time, plenty of action. Anything can happen. Let's see what can happen right now. Robel got the full amount. Throwing nice short elbows. Beautiful sight. Ladies and gentlemen, this sport is an art. It's just beautiful. It's not violent. You know, you have some gruesome things here and there, and that's just me being honest, but this is a sport that's just beautiful. It's a work of art. If you're an artist, you will understand, you know, a mixed martial artist, you know, they disciplined, humble, very polite. You know, down to earth human beings, you know. So Robel right now got the headlock. All right. Let's see what Teeters can do in this last 25 seconds of this last round. Right now, he needs something. He needs to dig deep. He needs to pull out something. He needs to go for broke right now. Rebellion can just be on the backhand, just moving around. Hands are very low right now. Oh, Robel is literally teeing off on him. All right. Oh, both guys try to attempt of a spinning back fist at the same time. Pretty amazing. That was awesome. All right. So far, I like the fight. Very enjoyable. You know, at the same time, you come out to see me fight whoever wins out this bout. It's going to be an amazing time. It's going to be a fun time. You know, I take nothing away from neither guys. They're both tough, tough fighters. You know, and I just know where I stand. And I know where I want to be. And from the place that I want to be, that's why I'm going to dominate. Remember that. Just saying. But hats off to both fighters. This is a very good fight. Very good fight. I wonder how this goes. I want to see what the decision is on this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three championship amateur rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. Two judges score the bout 30-27, and one scores the bout 29-28. All for your winner by unanimous decision. And still, DC Flyweight Champion, Robel Tesfaldez.